Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ's Rhino 3D class. Follow up the question a couple videos ago regarding how to hollow the back of the ring. I would like to talk about the command is called shell in Rhino. And again, if you're using the RhinoGold or GenVision matrix, you probably don't need to use this method because it does have the command for hollow the ring. However, this tutorial is for Rhino 3D user, and then of course you will learn a lot, go through all the video, even though you're using Matrix or RhinoGold. Let's get started. Before we get to hollow the ring, let's take a look on this command called shell. And shell is really strong command. I think it's starting with from Rhino 5. What it does is it can hollow out inside of the shape and make it consistent thickness. So let's try the first one. I'm going to use the shell command. It's just type it shell, S-H-E-L-L. And then thickness, let's set it as 1, or you can change the thickness. You could go ahead and pick up the surface you want to show, and then it will go all the way inside. Right? It applied to the poly surface or the shape after you bowling. So let's try this one too. Now this time I want to pick up the same command. You just hit enter or right click on your mouse. You can bring up the latest command you use. I want to show not only one face, I actually want to show three faces. So let's take a look. It will show all the way inside of that shape. Right. One of the restrictions is when you're using the shell, you need to have a flat surface. For example, this sphere I wanted to show, there's no way for me to show it. Let's try. Since this is completely round, the Rhino doesn't know where do you want to start it. So it has to have a flat surface. So let's take a look on this one. I'm going to show and I pick up this flat surface. And again, it will show all the way, follow the shape of what I want. Now there's a restriction when you have a combination for the straight and the curved surface. When you try to shell, for example, we want to shell from this flat surface, and then that will be no problem, go all the way inside. Or if we want to shell this surface, which is all the way flat, and you will have no problem either. However, if you try to shell on the surface that has a curve and also straight edges, then you might run into the problem. Let's take a look. It will tell you the shell result is not solid. So let's take a look where it's not solid. It probably will leave it, let me turn on the ghost view, and it will probably is right there. If you take a look underneath it, that part where will not be solid. So let's talk about how to shell this signet ring. It is a simple form. There's no extra cutting on the top or anything like that. We want to use the shell, and remember one thing: when we are making any of a model, we try to make a bottom half of a ring shank as solid as possible. Two reasons. First one is because when you are sizing a ring, the one on the bottom usually get cut. Either is added more metal or remove the metal. So let's try to keep it as solid as possible. Second reason is if you make it hollow, it's easier to get dent because that is the part hit the other places the most. All right, so we want to keep the bottom solid. Now, to do that, if we shell entire inside of a ring, it will shell all the way to the bottom. So we need to split this first. I'm going to use the curve from midpoint and snapping into the zero. And draw a line cross is wider than the ring shank. Then I'm going to split this ring by this curve. So now I have top and the bottom. To show the better view, I'm going to hide this one. So you can see the bottom is gone. But make sure that you close this, because for shell, you need to make sure that they are solid. So I'm gonna use the command called cap. I'm gonna type it cap and click it here. Let's use the command show. Let's set the thickness for 0.8 millimeter, and then let's go in to click on this surface. Then you will get this ring is hollow out from inside all the way. Then let's also turn on the button. Remember the button, since we split it, it's not solid. So let's do cap first. Make sure they are solid. Then we can go ahead to balling unit. So that's how we get this foam to be shell all the way the same thickness. Now let me move this one on this side. And let me bring up another one. To show this ring will be the same, we can use the shell, but you're gonna running into one of the problem. And of course we can split the ring like the first one, the top and the bottom. But the problem is, if you go in to look at inside of this interior right here, it has a lot of sharp corner, and the distance, for example, where the P, the straight bar there, it is less than 0.8 millimeter than we wanted to show, then you will run into a problem. Let's take a look what kind of problem we'll run into it. To save the time, I'm not gonna cut the model in half, but just want you to see. So let's type it shell. Then the same thing, we use 0.8 millimeter. Okay, here say shell result is not solid, and let's take a look on it. It's because this complicated design right here, and it's some of the distance is smaller than the distance we want to show, and so you will get this broken edges, right? And of course we are not going to use that. So that's redo. And the way we are going to work on it is we need a clean cutting tool. So let me move this outside. And what's the clean cutting tool is the original one that we have not cut out the text. We're going to use this one as our cutting tool. So I need to bring this ring back. So I'm going to use align tool and snap them back to the zero point. And let me move this one up a little bit. All right. So that way I have two pieces. One of the pieces is with the text and the other one is a clean cut. I'm going to change the color for that clean cut into the red one. Okay, so let's take a look on the front view. I'm going to scale it down, holding my shift. So I'm scaling it down all the way the same distance. Now we don't want to cut it too low to the bottom, so I'm going to scale 1D. To bring it down a little bit and bring this up. All right, in this result, it may not have exactly the same distance all the way, but that will work too. And so you can use the gumbo to do 1D scale to find the proper thickness that you want. All right, with that, all we need to do is bowling different. So this one is bowling out by this one. So then you will get a big chunk of the metal cut out to reduce your thickness. And also at the end of where the hollow foam will be rounded. In this case, you will get sharp edges, but you can always do fitted edges to make it round. Remember, always check the naked edges before you send it out for print. Basically, you send everything into the edge analyze. It's living under analyze. You have edge tool and you want to say show edge. And then you will show if it says this no naked edges, then you are good to go to making them into the mesh. To how to make the ring into the mesh and prepare for the casting, please look at my other video at the end of this video or see the link below. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a comment, let me know how I'm doing, and any other questions that you may have regarding this video or any other technique you would like to see in the Rhino 3D. Thank you. I'll see you next Monday.